Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon to the participants of International Conference. Let me introduce myself. My name is Agung Setiorini. I am a doctoral student in Agriculture Science in 11 Maret University. I am also a lecturer at the Agriculture Faculty University of Veteran Paku Nusantara Sukoharjo. I will present my research with the title Income and Feasibility Analysis of Rice Farming in Sabah Riset Kedua Wonogiri Regency, Central Java. Wonogiri has a topography of different areas. There are areas that are flat, wavy, step, and very step. Most of the photography is uneven with an average slope of 30 degrees. So, that it makes the condition of natural resources different. Most of the agriculture land in Wonogiri is not very fertile, rocky, and dry. However, based on the identification of the leading sector with the location question, agriculture was ranked first, followed by the livestock, forestry, and fishery sector. Wonogiri Regency has an artificial reservoir, namely Gajah Mungkur, a source of livelihood for fish and farmer, and a source of irrigation for rice field. Gajah Mungkur reservoirs dam several river, Sakas, the Kedua, Tetomoyo, Temon, Soluhulu, Alang, and several other rivers. The Upper Bengawan Solo River includes six subwatershed, namely Kedua, Alah Munggahan, Piroko, Upper Solo, Loriantoro, and Temon subwatershed. Kedua is a subwatershed of the Lam. The livelihood of most of the people who live around the Kedua subwatershed are farmers who cultivate agriculture in wetland, dry field or garden, and dryland. Food crop commodities cultivate include rice or paddy, crop, soybean, peanut, green bean, cassava, and sweet potato. In 2016, the agriculture sector contributed 32.8% of the gross income of Wonogiri Regency. They saw that the agriculture sector is still a major proponent of the economy in Wonogiri. There is a time to analyze the income and feasibility of rice farming in the Kedua Subwatershed Wonogiri Regency. Research sampling method. The sampling area was taken by purposive sampling. The selection of research site is categorized into upstream, middle, and downstream areas. In this research, the area that represent up the upstream in the determinant, namely Jatipurno. The middle region is represented by Jatisrono, and the downstream area is represented by Sidoharjo subdistrict. The method of the determining respondent was carried out by survey, and the number of respondents is 90 farmers. Analysis method. Cost. Total cost equal variable cost plus fixed cost. Revenue. Revenue is equal of the production price multiplied by total production. And net income or profit is total revenue minus total cost. RC ratio equal revenue divided cost. Research and discussion. The characteristic of respondent farmer. Farmer characteristics are very important and directly related to rice farming activities. Social sector include farmer X, education, experience in rice farming, and a number of farmer family members. Based on table 1, it is known that most of the eggs of the head of the family of farmer household belong to the productive eggs group. Eggs affect the absorption and division and decision of farmer in implementing technology or innovation. A person in the productive age generally has maximum participation given that human labor has limitation on maximum ability to work. The education of the head of farmer household is in a low category because it is equivalent to elementary school, where it affects a person's way of thinking, attitude, mentality, and determine a person's tendency to respond to new things. Low education will hinder in division of information and technology. Most of the respondent farm households have more than 30 years of farming experience. Long farming is a benchmark for farming experience, so it is hoped that the longer farmer carries out his farming activities, the more experience will be in the running his farm and better in managing his farm. The number members of the respondent farm household is mostly between 1 up to 3 members. The household structure category determines the availability of labor. Farm household in the study area use labor outside the family in running their farm because most of the family members migrated out of town. Family workers and mostly just consist of the head of the household and his wife. At the time of land preparation, planting, and harvesting are all carried out by workers outside the family. While plant care and fertilization activities are carried out by workers in the family. Cost, income, and efficiency of rice farming. Farming costs are calculated based on the amount of money actually spent by farmer to finance their farming activities, which include variable costs and fixed costs. The variable costs include the cost of purchase of seed, fertilizer, labor costs, rental equipment, and transportation costs. Fixed costs include tax and depreciation costs of workers of agriculture equipment. Based on Table 2, show that the average variable cost is ₹19,807,381. The largest variable cost is the labor cost of 9,807,381. 39,620 rupiah, which is equivalent to 45.64%. The second largest cost, namely the cost of fertilizer, amounting to 3,172,743 rupiah, equivalent to 27.32. Fixed cost is 966,200 rupiah. The average fixed cost is the cost of depreciation of the equipment and the cost of land tax. The large average cost structure is depreciation cost, around 873,196 rupiah per hectare per year. Rice farming income calculated by subtracting income from rice farming cost. Based on Table 3, it is known that the average revenue is 29,464,858 rupiah per hectare per year, with an average farming cost 20,773,581 rupiah per hektar per year. So that the income is 8,691,277 rupiah. Table 3. So the RC ratio of the rice farming in the Tuduang, Sabah Tersebut. Monogiri Regency is 1.42. Indicated that the RC ratio more than 1, that farming is profitable and feasible to develop. Conclusion. Following are the conclusion from the research on income analysis and feasibility of rice farming in the Ketubang Sabah Tersebut Monogiri Regency. First, the average total cost is 20,773,581 rupiah per hektar per year, with the revenue 29,464,858 rupiah per hektar per year. So that income is 8,691,277 rupiah. RC ratio of 1.42 indicated that farming is profitable and feasible to develop. Okay. Thank you for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.